Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about how to program a timer with 8051 microcontroller. Generally in 8051 we have two timer registers. So in each timer is 16 bit register, we have timer 0 and timer 1. So those timers can be programmed by using timer mode register. We have a T mode, so it is an 8 bit register. The lower 4 bits, gate, C/T bar and M1, M0, this lower LSB bits for timer 0. Likewise, gate, C/T bar and M1, M0, the MSB 4 bits for timer 1. We will see one by one bit. The first bit is gate. If gate pin is 1, then timer will run only with hardware control. And if gate pin is 0, the timer will run only with software control. So in our program, we are going to store a delay. We are going to load a delay in a program, and then we will control the timer by means of software. So always this pin will be 0 in software programming. The next bit is C/T bar, whether timer will act as a counter or timer. If this bit is 0, then it will act as a timer. If this bit is 1, then this will act as a counter. The next two bits are M1 and M0. Which will define the modes of 8051. So here we have four modes are there, M1 and M0. If 00 means it is called 13 bit timer mode 0. If it is 01, it is called mode 1, it is called 16 bit timer. And if it is 10, it is called mode 2, 8 bit auto reload. And if it is 11, it is called mode 3, split timer. So in this video, we are going to see about programming for mode 1, 16 bit timer. Always, whenever we are doing a program for timer, at first we will load a TMOD register. We will intimate 8051 that in which timer we are going to use, in which mode we are going to perform, whether we are going to perform as a timer or counter. We will intimate everything through TMOD register. So this is the first step. The second step is we will say basic program. Basic example, find the values of TMOD register to operate as timer in the following modes. For example, they have given us here, we want to find a TMOD register values for mode 1 and timer 0. So we want to use timer 0. So timer 0 means what happens? This bit will be there. So we are going to perform software control. So the first bit is, if you see here, for MSB will be 4 bits. MSB will be 4 bits. Why 4 bits? Because it is timer 1. So here in this example, they have asked for timer 0. So the MSB 4 bits are not used, and we will use only the lower LS 4 bit of LSB. So at first, gate pin, whether gate pin should be 1 or 0. We are going to give a delay by using software. So this bit will be 0. Then we are going to use as a timer. So it will be 0. Then we need to perform mode 1. Mode 1 means 01. So it will be 01. So what is the corresponding value? So it will be 01H. This is the value. This is the value which will be loading in your program. TMOD. Mode TMOD, 01H. So now we will take another example. Mode 2 timer 0 and mode 2 timer 1. So now what happens here? So the first bit will be gate. We are going to use both timer 1 and as well as timer 0. So at first we will do for timer 1. So for timer 1, the gate pin will be 0. Why 0? Because we are going to give a delay by means of software. So it is 0. And then we are going to perform timer. So this bit will be 0. And then we are going to perform mode 2. For mode 2, what is the value? 10. The same operation, we are going to use timer 0, so it will be 0010. Okay, so the corresponding hexadecimal value will be loaded in the TMOD register. So this is how we will find a TMOD register to load into an 8051. Now we will see how to write a program. Before writing a program to generate any waveforms or any timer delays, we require some time period, and we require how much clocks it should be high and how much clocks it should be low. Always timer will take 1 by 12th of your clock frequency. always timer will take 1 by 12th of your clock frequency. So how to program a timer in mode 1? At first, whatever is the clock frequency, the 8051 clock frequency will be in the range from 10 megahertz to 20 megahertz. So the corresponding value will be divided by 12, and then we will load into your timer. We will switch on the timer. We will load a delay. We will load a delay. So here the maximum delay we can give is FF. So corresponding FF. So we'll be giving delay value. Suppose, for example, if you are giving delay value as something called FF F2, we will load into your timer register TH and TL. The F2 will be loaded in the TL and FF will be loaded in the TH register. So what happens here? The timer will be keep on running. So I will keep on checking the overflow flag. So from FFF2, it will be increments to FFF3, F4, F5, F6, F7, F8, F9, FA, FB, FC, FD, FE, and then FF. So after FFFF, it will rolls to the 000 back. So that time, overflow flag will get set. That time, your timer will get stopped. So once you do the program, you will come to understand. Before that, how to calculate a delay. For example, the XTL oscillator frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. And then we will divide this value by 12. So this will be given in the program. 11.0592 megahertz is the corresponding frequency, XTL frequency. So at first we need to divide the corresponding oscillator frequency by 12. So we will get the corresponding frequency. So what is 11.0592 megahertz divided by 12? So what is the corresponding frequency we will get? We will get 921.6 kilohertz. This is the first step. In whatever frequency, XTL frequency they are giving, we should divide by 12 and we should find the frequency. And then we should convert the frequency into time. So T is equal to 1/921.6 kilohertz. So what is the time? It is 1.085 microseconds. So this is the corresponding time period for your timer. So from this we will divide it for delay. Okay, so for example, a desired time delay is something called we need to this is for whole time period. So now from this whole time period will be divided by 5 ms. I want to generate square wave. For example, I want to generate square wave for 5 ms period. So how will you do it? So 5 milliseconds divided by overall time period, 1.085 microseconds. We are dividing the how much time we want in the on time and how much time we want in the off time. So 5 milliseconds divided by 1.085 microseconds. So this will give a value called 4608 clocks. Okay, and then we need to find a delay value. The maximum delay is FFFF. The corresponding decimal value is 65535. And then you can ask me that why it's called 65536. Because to overflow flag to get occur, we need one more transition from FFFF to 000. So that's why 65536. So from 65536 minus 4608. 65536. Minus 4608, we will get the corresponding delay for 5 milliseconds. So it will be 60928. So this is the corresponding delay we should load into the timer. So now what happens once you load into the timer? It will start from 928, 29, 30, 31 until it becomes 65536. It will be keep on in the on time. So convert the result of 60928 into a hexadecimal value. We can load the corresponding decimal value and as well as hexadecimal value as a delay value. So now if you convert the 60928 into hexadecimal value, it will be EE00H. So this is the corresponding delay value. Then you load the delay in timer. So this is a step we should convert, we should find a delay. So now we will do some basic example. So assume that XTAL has a 11.05 MHz. What value do we need to load into a timer's register if you want to have a time delay of 5 milliseconds? So for on time, for example, I want to create a square waveform. Okay, for on time of 5 milliseconds or off time of 5 milliseconds, I want to generate a pulse width. Okay, in the question they have states that show the program for timer 0 to create a pulse width of 5 milliseconds on pin 2.3. So now we will write start to write a program. So at first we will clear the pin, pin 2.3, and whatever before values there, it will be get erased out. And then we are going to use mode 1 register, we are going to perform mode 1, and we are going to use timer 0. So move tmod comma asterisk 01h, because we are going to perform mode 1 comma timer 0. So that's why it is 01. At first we have seen for tmod register, right? By using the tmod register, we have find the move tmod comma 01h. This is the value. So and then we will load a delay value, move tl naught comma asterisk. So here the delay value is for 5 milliseconds EE00H. So 00 we will load in the lower bits and EE will be loaded in the higher bits. So move tl naught comma ash 00H and move th naught comma ash EH0EH. So this is the corresponding delay value we have loaded. And then once you load the value, now what happens? So already we have cleared the pin. So in the question they have told that create a pulse width of 5 milliseconds. So now set bit port 2.3. By setting the bit, what happens? Port 2.3 goes high. Port 2.3 goes high. It becomes 1. And then set bit timer 0. So by giving this line, it will start the timer. It will start the timer. And then what happens here? Once timer starts, what happens? From EE00, EE01, 02, 03, 04, it will keep on going until it becomes overflow gets occur, until overflow get set. Okay, so here once timer gets start, we will be monitoring the corresponding overflow flag. So for that, jump if not bit set, jump JNB TF naught. For timer 0 it's TF naught, and for timer 1 it is TF1, overflow flag again. So it will jump in the same line. Jump if not bit set. Okay, if overflow flag is not set, jump in the same line. It will be keep on looping here itself. So once overflow flag gets set, what happens? It will come out of the loop. Then I will clear the pin. I will clear the port 2.3, and then I will stop the timer. Or not, and then I will clear the overflow flag. So this is a basic program to generate a basic single pulse width of 5 milliseconds in a timer in A051. In upcoming videos, we will see how to generate a square wave by using A051 and how to perform mode 2 in A051. We will see one by one in upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.